Hey there, welcome back. In this lesson, I'm going to cover what is nearby search request and what are the required request parameters that we need to make an HTTP call. Finally, I'll be showing you how the output response object will look like. The first thing, what is nearby search? Nearby search is a part of Google Places library in the Maps JavaScript API. It allows us to get different places based on location, which could be either user's current location or any other location that you want to get nearby places from. It also allows us to filter the search result based on, of course, location and type and radius and so on. Let's take a look at the parameters that we need in order to get the places from the nearby search request. As you can see, the nearby search request URL is pretty straightforward. It has https maps.googleapis.com/maps/api and the API that we want to use, which is place/nearby search. It has a few required route and query parameters. It has one required route parameter, which could be either JSON or XML. This will determine what format the output response object will be. After that, there are four required query parameters. Let's take a look at them one by one. The first one is key, which is the actual API key that we can get from the Google's Cloud Console. The second one is the location, which will be latitude and longitude as a single value separated by a comma. The third one is the type. The value would be restaurant, school, and so on. And you can see all the types that we can use inside our application in here. Then the radius, which means how far you want to get the places from, which must be in meters. So if your search range is 5 kilometers, the value would be 5,000. Once the request is complete and everything goes well, you will get an output in a JSON format like the screenshot on the right. As you can see, the results array will have a list of places and you can see some information on each place like name, rating, and so on. The output results array will have only up to 20 places. And if you want to get the next 20 places, you will need to make a separate request. Hey, if you want to know more about Google Maps API and how you can use it to enhance location-based services in your JavaScript or Vue.js app, check out my course link in the description below. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video.